As a service engineer, one of the most useful tools in my toolkit is this precision machinist level. This durable, highly accurate Haas branded precision machine level is probably my most trusted tool. I use a precision level on nearly every customer visit that I'm assigned to, large and small. You'd be surprised how many customers think they have a problem with their machine when in fact their machine is not leveled. If you're having dimensional problems, parts out of spec, or issues with poor surface finish or chatter, the problem is often the level of your machine. We offer an inch version with a 2/10 graduation, a metric version with a 0.02 millimeter graduation. They are thermally stable, repeatable, and easy to calibrate. Let me show you how easy it is to use. Make sure you clean both surfaces of the level and the machine table that it will be sitting on. Place the level parallel to the center T-slot in the center of the table and take note of the bubble's location. Now, rotate the level 180 degrees. The bubble should be in the same place. If it's not, the level needs to be calibrated. The steps to calibrate the levels are simple. Remove the plastic cap from the side furthest away from the small vial. Use the provided adjusting tool to loosen one of the nuts, then turn the other nut clockwise or counterclockwise to center the bubble in the vial. You may need to repeat this process a couple times to get the bubble center. Now you're ready to go. I'm going to show you a quick example of how to level your mill. Start with the X and Y axis in the middle of travel, then place the calibrated level in the middle of the table with a large vial parallel to the X axis. Both the center leveling screws should not be touching their pads at this time. You would then raise the low end of the machine until the bubble is in the center of the vial. The machine is now rough leveled side to side. Rotate the level 90 degrees, making it parallel to the Y axis, and then let the bubble settle. Raise the low end of the machine until the bubble is in the center of the vial. Now the machine is rough leveled front to back. You may need to go back and forth a couple times to get the bubble center in the large vial for both X and Y axis. Now we need to check for twist and bow. This is the fun part of the leveling process, and the fine adjustment here makes all the difference in the world and how your machine performs. Start with the table in the front of the machine and the level parallel to X. Make note of the bubble's position and adjust the low end of the machine to bring the bubble in the center of the vial. Jog the Y axis to the back of the machine and look at the bubble to see which side of the machine is low. Adjust the leveling screw on the low side of the machine to raise the machine until the bubble is in the center of the vial. Jog the Y axis back to the front of the machine and look to see which side of the machine is low. Adjust the leveling screw on the low end of the machine to bring the bubble back to the center of the vial. Repeat the process until the bubble is centered. With each adjustment, the bubble will get closer to the center of the vial. When the bubble is centered at both ends of travel, we've removed the twist in the base casting. Now we can lower the center leveling screws to touch their pads. Next, let's check the bow to make sure the center leveling screws aren't too high or too low. Keeping the level in the middle of the table, rotate the level parallel to the Y axis. Make note of the bubble in the large vial as you jog Y from the front to the middle and then to the back of the machine. Adjust the center leveling screws in small increments, the same amount on each side until the bubble is centering the vial. Now remember, only make small and equal adjustments to the center leveling screws. So now we're gonna move over to the lathe and check the level. We'll use the two vials to measure the X and Z axes respectively. We will position the long vial parallel to the X axis This allows us to measure the twist along the Z or side to side. We'll use the short vial to measure the tilt of the machine left to right. Once the level is calibrated, place a large mag base on the face of the turret. Take the calibrated level and place it on top of the mag base. Top the bottom of the mag base around until the bubble is centered in the large vial. Pay close attention to the bubble in the small vial. If it's not centered, jog Z to the center of travel, then adjust the tool leveling screw on the low end of the machine evenly to raise the machine halfway, and lower the other side of the machine evenly till the bubble is in the center. Repeat the step if necessary. Now, look at the bubble in the large vial, which is parallel to X. As you jog the Z back and forth of the length of the travel, raise the low end of the machine to bring the bubble to the center of the vial. Repeat this process until the bubble is center in the large vial. With each small adjustment, the bubble will get closer to the center of the vial. If the machine has center leveling screws, lower the center leveling screws and apply about 5 to 10 degrees of pressure to the leveling screws and check it again. You may need to do this a few times to keep the bubble in the center of the vial. For more information and Haas service videos, visit HaasCNC.com, and thanks for watching.